Lord, you are said to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, you came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, you are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Look with favor, Lord God, on our petitions, and in our trials, grant us your compassion and help, that consoled by the presence of your Son, whose coming we now await, and we be tainted no longer by the corruption of former ways. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, will God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On that day, a shoot shall sprout from the stump of Jesse, and from his roots a bud shall blossom. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, a spirit of wisdom and understanding, a spirit of counsel and strength, a spirit of knowledge and of fear of the Lord, and his delight shall be the fear of the Lord. Not by appearance shall he judge, nor by hearsay shall he decide, but he shall judge the poor with justice, and decide aright for the lands afflicted. He shall strike the ruthless with the rod of his mouth, and with the breath of his lips he shall slay the wicked. Justice shall be band around his waist, and fullness a belt upon his lips. Then the wolf shall be a guest of the lamb, and the leopard shall lay down with the kid. The calf and the young lion shall browse together, with the little child to guide them. The cow and the bear shall be neighbors, together their young shall rest. The lion shall eat hay like the ox, the baby shall play by the cobra's den, and the child laid his hands on the adder's lair. There shall be no harm or ruin on all the holy mountain, for the earth shall be filled with knowledge of the Lord, as water covers the sea. On that day, the root of Jesse, set up as a signal for the nations, the Gentiles shall seek out, for his dwelling shall be glorious. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. O God, with your judgment, endow the king, with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. Justice shall flower in his days, and profound peace till the moon be no more. May he rule from sea to sea, and from the river to the ends of the earth. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. He shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. May his name be blessed forever, as long as the sun his name shall remain. In him shall all the tribes of the earth be blessed. All the nations shall proclaim his happiness. Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever. Alleluia, alleluia. Behold, our Lord shall come with power. He will enlighten the eyes of his servants. Alleluia, alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. Jesus rejoiced in the Holy Spirit and said, I give you praise, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows who the Son is except the Father, and who the Father is except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Turning to the disciples in private, he said, Blessed are the eyes that see what you see. For I say to you, many prophets and kings desired to see what you see, but did not see it, and to hear what you hear, but did not hear it. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The great part of being in a high school is that the young ones are here among us and they teach us. We're supposed to be teaching them, but they teach us. What have your children taught you? What are the lessons that your children gave to you, your nieces, your nephews? What have the young ones taught us? We're so busy trying to form them, and rightfully so, to share our wisdom, and that's true. What would the young ones teach us? It's so much better at Christmas when there's young ones, because then we're excited for them as we remember our experience of those Christmases past. They remind us again of how excited we should be for the season that we take for granted. In preparation for Christmas, we do all these different things, but the older we are, it seems like the more there is that weighs us down. And the children teach us to drop that for just a moment. The marvelous part about being able to worship is we have a chance to get a break from what weighs us down. A chance to remind ourselves again that in the end, all will be well. In the end, Jesus will indeed make it better. But in the meantime, we have a moment to appreciate what the young ones have taught us. It struck us in our track. It's like, wait, I'm the adult here. And yet, out of the mouths of babes, today we take a moment that what was hidden from us who are so distinguished and diplomated and whatnot, the young ones remind us, by the way, look at this. They say to us, Uncle, Mom, Dad, Aunt, look at this. What do they teach us? Jesus works through all sorts of people, the most unexpected. And sometimes, student, teacher, those roles have switched. Mentor, the one to be mentored, the roles switch. Those are beautiful moments. In these Advent days, let us appreciate what our children have taught us. We offer our prayers. We pray for our Northwest Catholic High School, for the students, faculty, staff, administration, family, friends, benefactors, and alone, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Joseph, for whom this Mass is offered. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for those who are sick in any way, remember the special way of this ennobled. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the dearly departed, that from their place in heaven they may guide us still. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for the prayers of our hearts. Lord, help us to live this day in the great light of the gospel story. Guide us in our days. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Root of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation. congregation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted of the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good of all this holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come we pray to our rescue, protection, and your mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Your Word, who made all things, who sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin. Fulfilling your will again for you, a holy people. He stretched out his hands as he endured his passion so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so the angels and all the saints would declare your glories with one voice to be acclaimed. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this, remembering me." Mystery of faith. When we eat this bread
and drink this cup,
we proclaim your death, O Lord,
until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered in one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Leonard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Joseph, you have called this world to yourself. Grant that he was united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all have died in your mercy. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, and with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world, blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord.